Hey guys, my name's Sam and welcome to the first ever PrepMedic DIY. In this week's video, I'm going to show you a simple trick on how to organize your syringes on scene when you have multiple medications drawn up ready to administer. So a lot of times in EMS and critical care, we have to drop multiple meds that are not always given right away. That means that we are oftentimes storing syringes in pockets, placing them on counters, and subsequently losing them or having the plungers pushed down, losing some of that medication. So this device here is an old trick that I was taught by an old critical care nurse. And what it involves is caps that you can take. You can place this key ring on the front of a uniform, you can place this on a flight suit in whatever bag you're carrying, and it gives you an easy way of storing these syringes somewhere that's easily visible, they're organized, and it prevents the plunger being pushed down so you're not losing medications. While this might not be a huge deal for amiodarone or epinephrine, it becomes a much bigger deal when we're talking about narcotics. This is a relatively easy device to make. You only need four main things. So you're going to need a cap for a syringe, and preferably you want a cap that extends slightly beyond the lure lock. You will also need a male lure lock cap, and then you'll need a key ring and a drill. Now this drill has a 1/8 size drill bit on it, but that will slightly depend on how big your key ring is. You really want to match those two up as much as possible. So the first step is going to be to open your syringe cap and your male lure lock cap, and we want to put these together as soon as possible. So infection risk is very real with syringes, and while this device is still far better than just shoving an uncapped syringe in your pocket, we still want to keep the tip of this as clean as possible. Now, as always, you need to follow your own agency's infection prevention policies in anything I'm talking about. So the next step, once these two are connected, is going to be identify a side on the wall of that cap that you can drill through. Now this cap in particular has a little bit of plastic inside of it. I can drill through that and it's not actually going to damage the seal of this cap at all. Other brands will not have that capability and you'll have to be careful not to nick the interior plastic. We're then going to take the drill and we're going to line it up on the wall of this cap and we're going to drill down and withdraw. It's pretty simple. And finally, the last step is going to be taking the key ring and we're going to thread that around through the cap and let that hang. Now, this technically is a one-time use. Once again, you have to fall back on your facility's cross-contamination rules and infection prevention. You can repeat these steps as many times as you want to fill up the keychain with as many meds as you think is necessary for your job. All of the supplies I'm mentioning here today can be bought off of Amazon.com, so don't feel like you need to go and pilfer your EMS's supply closet or tactically acquire things from the hospital. So I know this is kind of an oddball video, and I appreciate you sticking with me. If you like this format of video, or you think this is something that would be useful, or you don't like it, please leave them in the comments down below, and I will see you next week.